Here's an easy fix for those in property management diagnosing a toilet. You'll notice in the bowl here, very slightly, you see the water ripples? But I'm also hearing water ripples. So when you see water flowing into the bowl, that means you need a flapper. What I'm hearing in the tank, though, is dripping. And that's going to be the fill valve. Let's pop that down on the seat there. Look at that. So this toilet needs both a fill valve and a flapper. So when it's leaking by that flapper down there, it's going into the bowl. And another test you can do is we tend to put food coloring, be it red, green, blue, whatever you want, into the top tank here. And we'll check about 5 minutes later or so, 2 minutes later, if the bowl changes colors. If it does, you need a flapper valve. But we tend to replace both most of the time. And these little guys here, they're just waiting to be swapped out. Look at how crusty, rusty that one is. I've seen worse though. Let's swap it out. Easy fix. First step in our case, shut off the water, make sure it's off. Flush the toilet. And we hold it open. That way all the water gets out of that top tank. You'd be good if you're just doing a flapper. Just do it at that. Heck, I even keep the water on half the time. We're also going to bend this rod a little bit more at an angle. We get these metal rods and we custom bend them. We'll get that over the top of the flapper. But at that point, we can get a bucket under here, start moving the water lines and all that, and just gut it and replace it. Should be self-explanatory, right? And if all else fails, get your helpful resident kitty cat pet, and he'll help you along. But right now, I gotta do this real fast. Don't get fooled by these handles. These are reverse thread. So if you want to tighten that up, go the opposite direction as per usual. No righty-tighty, lefty-loosey here. We'll snug that up by hand, and then I tend to give it just a nudge with some pliers. Oh, this guy's helping with the old parts. This one's inspecting up here. But what we did was got the new fill valve in there. We go with the Fluid Master ones and the flappers on there. These simply just snap down to the studs. What I like to do is try to get this rod somewhat over the center of the dealio and then pull it up and make sure things are not sticking it. Sort of feels like that's binding up on me a little bit. So I'm going to go through there and make sure we're on there nice. That way it doesn't... Here we go. This is stuck on the other side. Make sure we're not going to bind up and that's going to stick up, because that allows the toilet to run constantly and it'll fill constantly, and then we get a work order on it. Make sure your hose is attached. If you don't got a little dealio like we got, you got to add the little clip from the tool pouch that comes with the kit. And now I just turned on the water. We got CPVC lines here. Check for any leaks. I keep the old fill lines unless they start to go through and drip. But generally they haven't been an issue. But we switch them out to stainless if they are. Ben. Curiosity to get. Let the tank fill up. Checking for leaks. Any leaks under there, buddy? Any leaks? I don't see any. Slow to fill. Murky water. That'll clear up, though, I think. But I tend to set our water level just to the lower portion of this lip here. And once it hits that, it should shut off. And we can adjust that with this right here. Perfect. Just a little bit lower, but it still sits, and you'll see usually a water line on the bowl too. If it's not marked with the stamping, you'll notice just over time it sort of etches a line of where it should be. I try to match that, but generally you want, you know, say a half inch down from that tube there is good to go. And I rarely have to adjust these Fluid Masters after putting them in. So at this point, pull out our bucket and our rags and everything. Give it a little flush after dry things down. And see if anything's leaking. And our buddy the cat's here. Watch each and every step. Yeah, it's looking much better. So there you go, guys. Diagnose what your toilet needs and sort of basic understanding of how to swap now. Get down to the old flush nozzle here, as we like to call them.